الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. Gratitude is our final message on the point of positive thinking and the lessons that we are deriving from Surah Yusuf or Quran chapter 12. Gratitude. It is very important that we give thanks to Allah for all the blessings that He has endowed us with. And so when you read Quran chapter 12, verse 99, you find Yusuf alayhi wa ala nabiyyina salatu wa salam summarizing the blessings that Allah has given him and giving the thanks to Allah. Yusuf invited his parents to come to Egypt, and they came together with their brothers. And we all know that Joseph earlier on had a dream where he saw 11 stars together with the sun and the moon prostrating before him. So when he invited his parents to Egypt and they got to Egypt, فَلَمَا دَخَلُوا عَلَى يُوسُفْ, when they entered the office of Yusuf, now Yusuf received his parents as honorable guests. And he told them, welcome to Egypt. Udhulu means enter Egypt. But then what it actually means is that you are welcome to the city of Egypt. Inshallah, with the permission of Allah, Aminin, you are secured, you are safe. Now, and then he invited his parents to sit on the throne. Meaning, he honored them, he respected them. So he invited them to sit on the throne of authority. Now, then all of them, the custom was that as soon as you enter into the palace of the king, you bow in prostration. So the father, the mother, and the 11 brothers all fell in prostration. Now, Yusuf said, Ya Abati, oh my father, this is the interpretation of my earlier dream. The 11 brothers are the 11 stars. Then the sun and the moon are the parents. When he saw them prostrating before him, he said, this is the fulfillment of my dream. Now, my Lord, Allahu Akbar, he's attributed it to Allah. So whatever success you get, attribute it to Allah. Don't attribute it to your intelligence. Don't attribute it to your ability or your skills. He attributed that to Allah. My Lord has made it a reality now. And my Lord has always been good to me. Remember when he removed me from the prison, he's giving thanks to Allah. And he's singling out the individual favors that Allah has done him. My Lord has been good to me. He removed me. He's made my dream a reality. One. Number two, he removed me from the prisons. Now. And then he brought you also from the desert to a city. They were in the desert and Allah brought them. That is another favor. Joseph saw that as something done to him, even though it was also a favor to his father. Now, after Satan has sown some enmity between myself and my brothers, he attributed whatever happened between himself and the brothers to Satan. He didn't blame them. He didn't hold them responsible. He attributed it to Shaitan. Now, then he said, his Lord, Allah, our Lord, Latifun, Allah is ever kind. If Allah wants to be kind to you, once it pleases him to be kind to you, he will be kind to you. And Yusuf is giving you and I a very valuable information. Allah is ever kind. My Lord is kind to anything that pleases him. Now, if you are talking about scholars, if you are talking about people who know, my Lord is knowing, wise. There are people who know but they are not wise. Sometimes they misapply their knowledge. There are people people who are wise, but then they don't know. But Allah combines those qualities. And Yusuf, in giving thanks to Allah, referred to Allah as the knower and also wise. Now, this is the point of giving gratitude to Allah. He said, oh my Lord, God, indeed, أَعْتَيْتَنِي مِنَ الْمُلْكِ, you have given me something of power and authority. Allah gave him power. He became the prime minister. Eventually, he became the king. He succeeded the king. So he said, my Lord, you've given me power and authority. Now, وَعَلَّمْ تَنِي مِنْ تَعْوِيلِ الْأَحَادِيثِ, you also taught me the interpretation of dreams. He's giving thanks to Allah by mentioning the individual favors. Now, the original creator of the heavens and earth, Allah originated the creation of the heavens and earth. They were not there. Allah did not learn them from anywhere. So he's praising Allah with the action of Allah that is beyond the capacity of anybody. Now, Fatih al-Samawat wal-Ard, Fatih al-Samawat wal-Ard, the creator of the heavens and the earth. Now, this is indeed interesting. He said, Anta wali, you are my protector. Make Allah your protector. Yusuf told Allah that you are my protector in this world and in the next world. Who is your protector? Are you relying on the assemblyman of your area to protect you? Are you relying on the MP? Are you relying on the government? Make Allah your protector. Yusuf said, my Lord, Anta wali, you are my protector. You are my guide. You are my ally. Make Allah your ally. And Allah will direct those who can do anything positive for you towards you. Allah, you are my protector in this world and the next world. After giving thanks to Allah, he requested what is most important in the life of a believer. You may be a believer for 100 years, and then the 1 week that you will do in addition, you displease Allah and you die as a disbeliever. Yusuf asked Allah to let him die in submission to Allah. To let him die as a Muslim. So he tawaffani Musliman. When it is time for me to die, let me die as a believer. As a Muslim, a Muslim is the one who submits fully to Allah. Now, link me up after death with the righteous. When you die, pray that Allah should include you among the righteous. Because the righteous, when you love them, even if your deed is not up to their deed, Allah will include you among them because of your righteousness. See how good Joseph has been. Avoiding fornication, avoiding adultery. See how he consciously remembered Allah at all stages of his life. He himself was righteous, but humility got him asking Allah to include him among the righteous. He knew that there are other people who are more righteous than him. Or there were other people who were more righteous than him. So let's all pray to Allah to take our life in the state of Islam and also include us among the righteous. So wherever our work is not able to get us to, because of the righteous servants of Allah, Allah will include us among them. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.